Welcome to Watch Therefore. We're watching for our King, our Savior, Messiah Jesus. He's coming in the clouds for His people any moment, and He tells us to watch therefore and be ready, for you don't know the hour or the day of the coming of the Son of Man. Dov Schwartz here in northern Israel, the Sea of Galilee, where our Savior walked. And in the Bible, I'm reminded in Romans 1:16 that His Word says the gospel's to the Jew first and then to the Gentile. That's why we have our ministries, Blessing Israeli Believers, and Poured Out for the Nations. Now, we had a special opportunity to go to Uganda in Africa, and there we preached the gospel, made disciples. Our team got to work with pastors, but something else very special. We were able on the Naka Valley refugee camp to minister to about 360 orphans under the care of our pastor partner, Muhoza Lewi. So what I'd like to do is invite you to join me and our team in Uganda. Go with me on location to the Naka Valley refugee camp. Join me, join our team, and sense, feel the pleasure of our Father in heaven as we minister to His special children. Dov Schwartz here on special assignment here in Uganda, Africa, watching for this King to come, Messiah Jesus, and doing what He commanded until He does. Oh, so glad to be with you, our viewers of Watch Therefore, and we have a special program for you today, again, here on special assignment. Now, the Bible says in Romans chapter 1, verse 16, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God, the salvation for everyone who believes, to the Jew first, and then to the Gentile." You see, the gospel comes to us and goes out in covenant order, to the Jew first and then to the Gentile. The Bible doesn't say it used to be to the Jew first, but now it's to the Gentile. No, it says it is to the Jew first and then to the Gentile. We have our ministry. These are our marching orders. We have our ministry, Blessing Israeli Believers. And you see that frequently when you watch the program, Watch Therefore. But also, there's our ministry to the nations. To the nations. And the Lord has opened up incredible doors for us in Africa. Now, in the last 10 years, I've been to 9 African countries, seen thousands, tens of thousands pray to receive Jesus as Lord. Now they're watching, now they're getting ready for His coming. And through this time, we've been doing pastors' conferences where we help equip pastors here in Africa and how to share the gospel more effectively, how to watch for the coming of Messiah Jesus by doing what He commanded, and by preparing disciples of Messiah Jesus who are the faithful servant. So we preach the gospel, we make disciples in the churches, we have pastors' conferences, and through that, our effort is, and our goal even of this program, Watch Therefore, it's even our goal to do with this with you today, is to be a faithful servant who's watching for the Master to come, Matthew 24, Mark 13, Luke 21, but also to make disciples who are watching for this great King to come in light of all the signs that are around us. And so we're watching for Him to come. We're making disciples who are watching for Him to come, and we're doing what He commanded. Romans 1:16, He says to take the gospel to the nations, to make disciples of the nations. We're getting to do that. We have a pastor partner named Muhoza Lewi. We're going to have him on other programs. And through him and other wonderful relationships we have in Africa, we go to these special places and meet these special, precious souls and take the gospel to them. Now here's a reality. I don't like this reality, but I can't ignore this reality. In the West, over hundreds of years before our time, there have been great revivals. And the gospel changed the continents of Europe and America. And from Europe and America, the gospel has gone out for hundreds of years. And there have been fiery revivals and times of great exciting moves of the Holy Spirit in the from these areas, from North America and from Europe. But now there's a shift. And Europe, by and large, is quickly, and has been for a while, turning away from the gospel of Messiah Jesus. Oh, we are still responsible to get out the gospel wherever the Lord opens the door. There are wonderful, precious brothers and sisters in these places, in Europe, and even America now is doing the same thing, becoming secular and atheist and turning to other gods, where the first commandment is, thou shalt have no other gods. And so now what you see is this shift in Asia, this shift in Africa, this shift in persecuted countries in the Middle East and other places, where the Holy Spirit is moving and He's calling His people forth in these places and from other places to go to these places and to these precious souls with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And guess what? We've answered the call. We've answered the call, and we are getting to do these exciting things. When I say we, I can't do all of this by myself. We have administrators. We have prayer partners. We have staff people. We have camera people who are special brothers and sisters in Messiah Jesus. And we have people who are doing production work, all kinds of great things. Yes? We have people doing our websites. And these are people who the Lord has brought alongside with me to do exciting work. And the Lord has raised up partners to help us as well, which we'll talk about more later. So with regard to what we're doing here, we're getting the gospel out, we're making disciples, while also ministering to orphans and to widows. And I'll talk more about that in our next segment. But this, right here, what you're looking at, is the Naka Valley refugee camp. That's where I'm standing right now. And there are refugees here who are from many different countries. I'll name a few. From Somalia, from Ethiopia, from Eritrea, from the Congo, from Burundi, from Central African Republic. Just to name a few, DR Congo is represented here. And the Lord has given us relationships with a segment of these persecuted where we can come to them. They are refugees. They're included in this number are orphans, widows, pastors, and people from all different walks of life who have been displaced, who have fled ethnic violence, and they are here on this refugee camp. And guess what? Not only are they here, but the Holy Spirit of the living God is here with them. Yes? And He has brought us here to preach this gospel, to make disciples. Oh, it's been so exciting. It's been so exciting. We have been preaching the gospel. We have seen just on this trip that you're, you know, in the time of your viewing here, we have seen about 60 people in the churches pray to receive Jesus as Lord. Now, there are times where we do evangelistic gospel meetings where we'll see many more. In one event, we saw 1,500 pray to receive Jesus as Lord. But this trip, specifically, we've come to the churches, the congregations on this camp and in other places in Uganda to strengthen the body of believers in Jesus. And at those times, we have seen about 60 men, women, and children come forward and pray to receive Jesus as Lord. Oh, it's a very exciting opportunity. There's so much that we get to do here. And we have a team. On this trip, we have a team that has come from Texas and from Israel. And it's just been very exciting. Now, you can get on board and you can participate. Well, what do you mean? You want me to get on a plane with you and come to a refugee camp in Africa? I can't do that. Well, no, but there's other ways you can participate. And we're going to talk about that at our break. We're going to talk about that in this program and other programs as well. So we're going to take a break in just a minute. Don't go away. We've got some exciting things to share with you about how the Lord is working in Uganda, throughout all Africa, and here on the Naka Valley refugee camp. This is an exciting hour. We see all these things on the news, and we know that. But we also know this is associated to the birth pains. The ethnic violence that has brought these people here is associated with the birth pains, which point to the coming of our Messiah Jesus. So what I think we should do is prepare these special souls, these precious ones who are here, to watch therefore. We'll be back in just a moment. A little over 10 years ago, I was walking across a parking lot in Houston, Texas, and the Spirit of the Living God stopped me dead in my tracks and spoke this to my spirit. He said, "Pure and undefiled religion goes to orphans," with a very clear implication, "and you don't." Where was this coming from, I thought, but I know where it's coming from. It's coming from James 1:27 in the New Testament. Pure and undefiled religion before God and the Father is this: to visit orphans and widows in their trouble and to keep oneself unspotted from the world. Well, I had even taught on this passage, but I certainly wasn't doing it. And I looked up into the sky. I said, "But Lord, I don't know any orphans." And I began to learn that there are about 200 million of them in the world today, and He's well acquainted with them. Why? Why can I say that? Well, in Psalm 68:5, the Bible says, "A father of the fatherless, a defender of widows, is God in His holy habitation." Wow. Well, if I want to be like Him, if I want to follow Him, if I want to be His son, because I believed in the only begotten Son, Messiah Jesus, then I should care about the fatherless. Well, the Lord began to introduce me to some of those 200 million. I can't help everybody, and I can't help anybody but that I have His help. And so He began to introduce me sovereignly to pastors in Africa who care for orphans. And I began to go to Africa and minister in many different ways. And one of those things is to visit orphans and to help as the Lord shows me how to. Well, He's done that. I've spent about 10 years learning how to do special things, to appraise situations and to identify needs, and then to learn in prayer and through experience and from His Word and through relationships who know a lot more than I do, how to do certain things to help some of the orphans. And we've been doing these things, and we have a special partner pastor, Muhoza Lewi, a Congolese Rwandan who operates in 4 countries in Africa ministering to orphans. And since he has, in 3 of those countries, others helping him, he has moved to Uganda onto the Naka Valley refugee camp, where we are partnering with him as he's ministering to about 360 precious orphans that you've seen on the program today. And so we've identified 3 particular areas where we want to help. And we believe the Lord's called us and will help us to help. One is with regard to malaria. Malaria nets really help, as the malaria mosquitoes are prevalent in the evening. And some of these children have malaria nets to sleep under, and some of them don't. Also with water, malaria can be contracted through water, bad drinking water. So there's a couple projects I don't have time to go into right now, a couple ways we can help with regard to drinking water, with water wells and purifying machines and different things. That's one thing. The other is food. These children only eat once, sometimes twice a day. And we think they should eat three times a day because they're children of our Father in heaven. And so we have an idea of a small farming project, and we have people who can help us with this. And that's one way they can be able to eat three times a day, a small farming project that we can come alongside them with. And then thirdly, five of these precious orphans in the last year, year and a half, have died from malaria. We want to put a medical clinic there in their midst where medicine is available, diagnosis is available, care for these precious orphans so that not another one perishes from malaria on the Naka Valley refugee camp. These are a few ways we can step in now and help. And here's what I would ask you: to go to our Father in heaven and in Messiah Jesus' name, seek His face. Would He have you to come alongside us to be a father to the fatherless with our Father in heaven? If so, go to watchtherefore.tv and learn more. Sign up for our monthly newsletter, learn more, and even donate there for the precious children at the Naka Valley Refugee Camp in Uganda. Remember, watch therefore, Messiah Jesus is coming any moment. Welcome back to the program. At the beginning of the show, I talked to you about the significance of going to the nations with the gospel. And I want to talk to you now about the name of our ministry and why this very special name that the Lord has given us for the work we're doing. The Apostle Paul told the Philippian believers in chapter 2, verses 17 of the letter to the Philippians, he said that he was poured out like a drink offering, like a sacrifice. He was poured out for the faith of those in the nations who would believe in the Jewish Messiah, Jesus. His life was poured out like they would pour out a drink offering on the altar of the sacrifices in the Old Testament times of the Bible. And so Paul said, follow me, I'm following Christ. And a way we can follow him is to be poured out for the nations. And that's why our work in the nations is called Poured Out for the Nations. You can go to pouredoutforthenations.com and find out more about it. And so there's the philosophy or the mindset of what we're doing. We want to be poured out like Paul was for the faith of these precious ones here in Africa, here in Uganda, here on the Naka Valley refugee camp. Now, I want to talk to you about a story our Lord Jesus, he shared with his disciples. And we find it in the Gospel of Matthew. And he said this. He said, there was a great master who had a wedding feast. And he invited these very important people and notable people in society. The problem was they didn't see the significance of this feast or the master who was holding it. And they were too busy for this reason. And they were too busy for that reason. And it was just unimportant to them. And when the servants who had gone out inviting these people to the feast, when they went back and they reported it to the great master, he was infuriated. And he told them many things, one of which we see in Matthew chapter 22, verse 9. He said, therefore, go into the highways, and as many as you find, invite to the wedding. What does this mean? Those people, they didn't want to come, they can't come. So go where what the world would consider the less important people are. who aren't so busy with the things of this life and go invite them to my wedding feast. Now, the Bible teaches very clearly, and boy, is this part of the Watch Therefore message, that there's going to be a wedding ceremony in heaven. And after it, a great feast, a great wedding feast. And in the Jewish wedding, they would go, the father and the bridegroom, they would go to the bride and her father's house. Of course, the mother would be there as well. And the father of the groom and the groom would agree to pay a bride price for the bride to marry the groom. Our Father in heaven sent his only begotten Son, and Messiah Jesus agreed to pay the bride price. What was the price? The blood of the Lamb, the blood of Jesus Christ. He died on the cross for our sins. He was buried on the third day. He rose again. And he said this. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Why did he say that? Well, in the Jewish wedding ceremony, he would go and betroth the bride, but then go back to the father's house. There's no wedding yet. And the father would go, the son would go with the father and build on a place at the father's house. And then he would go get his bride and bring her to the father's house. The thing is, nobody but the father knew when he would approve the work the son had done, at which time the father would say, go get your bride. And that's why our Lord Jesus said, nobody but the father knows the hour or the day. And then the groom would come with a great procession. It was called by our Lord Jesus, the midnight cry. And he would come for his bride. What was the bride, the betrothed bride, what was she to be doing? She was to be faithful to the and prepared for the unannounced anytime coming of the groom. She was to be faithful. She was to be preparing herself, a spotless bride. You see, that's what we as believers in Messiah Jesus are to be doing. We don't know the hour of the day. And the Bible teaches this. Just like in the Jewish wedding, the groom would come with shouting and a procession and trumpets. The Bible says, for the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel and the trumpet of God. The dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive remain shall be caught up together with him in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we always be with the Lord. Hallelujah. And our Messiah Jesus, he told us when we see the signs that we see all around the world today that he spoke of concerning his coming. He said, watch therefore and be ready. Watch therefore and be ready. Why are we here at the Naka Valley refugee camp? We're here like the faithful servant in Matthew 24, Mark 13, Luke 21, watching for him to come. And we're ministering life to the precious souls here. There are orphans on this refugee camp. There are widows on this refugee camp. What are we to be doing? Pure and undefiled religion visits orphans and widows in their trouble and keeps oneself pure, unspotted from the world, preparing for the groom to come. Yes? So we are here ministering to orphans, ministering to widows, along with the other things I've mentioned before in this segment, in this show. And in future programs, we're going to unpack the opportunities that you have to partner with us here in Africa, where this shift that I mentioned earlier is in full swing. Think of this. Just last night, when I shared the gospel here on the camp, about 30 men, women, and children came forward to pray to receive Jesus as Lord. And we're working very hard all day, every day. So while they were still praising, while they were still worshiping, at the end of the service, our team left to drive an hour back to our hotel room. And then we went out to dinner. And so like 4 hours after we had left, we got a phone call. And what was the news? they told our pastor partner, the fire has fallen in the midst of the believers. The Holy Spirit has come down, and 4 hours later after we left, hallelujah, they were still worshiping and praising, and the Holy Spirit was moving across the body back and forth, touching precious ones who were there, showing them the orphans, you have a Father in heaven, and He loves you through Messiah Jesus, and by the presence of the Holy Spirit, you can know that. Precious souls were getting touched, and they said this, Pastor, we may be worshiping the Savior Jesus until the sun comes up because of His presence with us. His name is Emmanuel, God with us. Is He God with you? Have you received Jesus as Lord? Oh, listen, time is growing short. We're poured out for your faith too. Have you truly been born again? Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. He was buried, and hallelujah, on the third day He rose again. And the Bible says, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Cry out to Messiah Jesus. Ask Him to forgive you of your sins. Turn away from them and put your faith in this resurrected, soon coming King. Come and go with me to my Father's house. Remember to watch, therefore. Remember to be ready. Go to a church that reads the Bible, teaches the Bible, prays a lot, and is preparing for our King to come. And get about His business in the kingdom of God. Watch, therefore. Be ready.
Thank you for joining us for our program today. Our program is sponsored by the friends and partners of Watch Therefore Ministries. In future programs, we'll have many more Watch Therefore teachings from the Bible, worship, and exciting interviews with our believing partners in Israel and around the world. Please contact us at doveschwartz62@yahoo.com. That's doveschwartz62@yahoo.com. And if you would like to subscribe to our newsletter, you can fill out a contact form on the website, watchtherefore.tv. We also have audio programs available on our website, watchtherefore.tv. We are on social media, since it is an amazing tool to share the gospel and communicate with one another. Feel free to also find us there at Watch Therefore Radio and TV, Watch Therefore Radio and TV. Until next time, we're watching for King Jesus to return. Watch therefore and be ready.